Hey yo, real quick, I just want to give a quick shout out to my boy Farhan. He's been helping us out with the editing of the pictures in the background you guys see up there when I talk. So if it looks really good, please go out there and support him. His link will be in the description below. Yo, what's up Giants fans? It's just No Name again. I wanted to just get a quick video out on the recent signings we did with Golden Tate, Marcus Golden, and how this all falls into place in Dave Gettleman's plan, if he has a plan, and then like how we should approach the draft now, because everything's just been really confusing since the OBJ trade, especially this Golden Tate signing. So you know, let me get into it. So the New York Giants signed Philadelphia wide receiver Golden Tate to a 4-year, $37.5 million deal with $23 million guaranteed. This was really like a head-scratcher move, I guess you could say. It's not bad, it's not terrible, but at the same time, it's not great. I mean, you could even argue it wasn't a good deal. Technically, when you go by the year-by-year money in today's NFL, we got a good deal for Golden Tate. He is a starter. He was a number one receiver in Philadelphia. He was number one receiver in Detroit before that. And in fact, the Seahawks let him go because they couldn't afford him. So year-by-year, it's like $9 million a year. It's not a bad deal at all. But his age, he is getting up in age. He's going to turn 31 before the season begins. And by the time this deal is over in 4 years, he'll be 35 years old. So he's either gonna fall off this season or win the future season that we have him. Because listen, this is no knock on Golden Tate. I like to clarify right now, Golden Tate is a good receiver. He's not gonna be a top 10 receiver. He's not gonna be one of the flashy ones, but he's tough and he's a team player. Also, he has great hands. And like, I'm really worried because of his age. Listen though, Tate, great hands, tough, team player. And that kind of matches what Gettleman's message has been since he came over here. He wanted tough players, and he wanted players that played for the team. So I'm guessing, I don't know, man. I always thought that Odell played for the team. Obviously, you could tell, like, at times he had his own brand in mind, himself in mind. But yeah. But yeah, I mean, this is really the type of player Gettleman would go for. Tate. Like I said, he's really good. He's a steal in terms of yearly money. Obviously, he's not going to fill in the void that Odell left, but since he's a team player, I think this would allow us to have a good number one wide receiver while being able to spread the ball like we did in the second half of the season last year. If you guys noticed, when the offense was going off, it was when we were spreading the ball around to everybody. It was during Odell's injury. Like, we weren't focusing on one player. We were running the ball well, and we were spreading the ball amongst all of receivers. So, yeah, I mean, it's a good pickup in that sense. And Tate, like, just from quick stats for you guys, last year before he got traded to the Eagles with the Lions, he had 44 catches for 517 yards and 3 touchdowns. Then when he went over to the Eagles, he never really got the time to adjust. So it was only 30 receptions with 278 yards and 1 touchdown. But every year before that, he's had close to 1,000 yards. From 2014 to 2018, he's almost always reached 1,000 yards, with the exception being 2018 and 2015. But yeah, he's a good receiver. I think he's going to bring a good voice to the locker room, be a good leader for us, and just like a good role model in general. Now, as I said, my concern is age, but my concern is also size. He's only like 5'11", 5'10", maybe, but all of the Giants receivers now, we always had short receivers these past couple of years, and people are like, oh, height doesn't really matter. It does when it comes to possession catches, and we've been missing that big receiver for a while. So I always thought, like, in the later rounds in the draft, we should have went after somebody like a little Jordan Humphrey. Funnily enough, who's one of the tallest receivers in the draft class, even though his name is Lil Jordan. I always thought we should have targeted a tall receiver towards, like, the fifth or sixth rounds, but now I don't know if we're actually going to go for any receivers at all in the draft. I definitely think we should not be going for any receivers within the first 3 rounds, because it's not needed, at least for this upcoming year. Also, another reason this was a head-scratcher, and you could argue this was bad, is because he has $23 million guaranteed, and it really all goes back to Odell trade and his contract that we made him sign last year. we already paid him $21 million or something. And we were supposed to pay him $17 million this year if we kept him, which is why there was a $16 million cap hit. So I'm just like, I don't know if we should be giving $23 million guaranteed, fully guaranteed, to a receiver that's going to be 35 by the time his contract is done. I don't believe in that. I think that's a bad move. So it's like two sides to this. You guys, tell me your opinion down below if you think it's good or bad. But let's move on to the next Golden. Now, for Marcus Golden, outside linebacker slash edge rusher from Arizona. It's kind of weird how we're signing a lot of Arizona people. We're definitely signing them because they have a connection to James Betcher when he was there. And it makes me angry because we've let go of a lot of good Giants defensive players simply because they didn't fit in James Betcher's defense or his scheme. And that it just makes me angry. I don't know why we're making our defense like all former Cardinals. But this one, I'm not that angry about. I'm actually really excited for this one. He's only on a one-year deal. The details are still not out yet. And this is a very low-risk, high-reward deal. I absolutely love this, the signing. Marcus Golden, he's been injured, and that's why you haven't really heard his name these past couple of years in the NFL. But he was drafted in 2015. He came out his rookie year, got four sacks, two forced fumbles. You know, pretty average rookie year. But then he had a big jump in his sophomore year, 2016. He had 12 and a half sacks, four forced fumbles, QB hits, like 22 QB hits. And he played all 16 games. It was just, he had an amazing year in 2016. Then he was unfortunately injured in 2017. Missed out. He only played four games, so he missed the rest of the season. He was an ACL tear. So yeah, it was a serious injury, and there's always that risk of a player never getting back to form, getting back to how good they were before an injury. And then when he came back in 2018, the Cardinals, they switched from James Betcher to, I'll be honest, I don't know who their defensive coordinator is now, but they switched defensive coordinators. So they didn't really use Golden as he was used in the previous regime's defense. He was more of a role player here, which is why when he played in only 11 games, he only had 2.5 sacks in the season. So looking at it without all that context, you'll be like, yeah, he's definitely dropped off because of the injury from 12.5 sacks to 2.5 sacks and QB hits from 22 to 6. But when you factor in the injury, him missing an entire season, him recovering for part of 2018 and then not even being used as a starter in 2018, the context sort of provides that, hey, maybe this guy still has the juice. Maybe after the recovery and when put into a starting position, he could really show himself and get back to at least 10 sacks a year, which is why I love that we signed him to only a one-year deal, because that means if he gets injured again, we're not really losing that much money. And even if he gets back to form, we have him for that one-year deal. We could extend him at the end of next offseason. So I'm really excited for Marcus Golden. I hope he comes back strong, and I hope he just gives the Giants a good chance and gives our defense a nice jolt. And now in terms of that, I think we should let go of Kareem Martin, who was also a James Betcher guy from Arizona, because Marcus Golden would be filling in his spot, and Lorenzo Carter should be getting a starting spot this year. I think he's going to take a jump, as many rookies do their sophomore year. So I want Lorenzo Carter on one end and Marcus Golden on the other. And then if we draft Devin White or somebody, him in the middle next to Alec Ogletree, if we get another really good pass rusher somewhere down the line, put them in there in our rotation. But yeah, I think that's how the lineup is for now. In general, the defense seems to be moving in the right direction given all of the trades and people we've let walk away. So yeah, and that's about it for the latest signings. Golden Tate, head scratcher, Marcus Golden, I love it. That's about all I have to say on the Goldens. I just really want to touch really quickly before I forget on the Anthuan Bethea signing. That was also another head scratcher because he's 34 years old. Obviously, there's a risk having a 34-year-old strong safety come in, but here's the thing. He's probably the best 34-year-old strong safety on the market because he led the league in tackles last year. Let me just pull up the stats for you real quick. My bad, he's a strong safety, but look at his stats last year. Even though he was 33 last year, he had 121 total tackles and 100 solo tackles, leading the league safeties. That's more than Landon Collins, that's more than Adrian Amos, who I really hope they got him, but he signed with the Packers. It's more than LaMarcus Joyner. It's more than any top young safety you could think of out there, because it's the most by any safety in the NFL. Now then, looking at him in general, he's kind of inconsistent, because the year before that, he only had 57 tackles, and then before that, he had 110. So depending on where we play him, I think we should put him in at the free safety spot, because I don't want Curtis Riley to come back. He should be average. That's what I'm hoping for. We can't replace Collins, even though I think Peppers has a really good chance of doing that in the years to come. And in fact, he could be a really good mentor for Peppers. I think that's why we signed him. We signed him knowing that we were going to get Peppers next week in the OBJ trade. I think he's going to be a really good mentor for him. Because remember, you guys got to remember, Julius Peppers, he played a linebacker in college. So that's why his rookie year as a safety wasn't exactly the greatest. He was adjusting, and then last year he popped off. I think having this mentor, a really good veteran, the best tackling safety in the business, is really good for him. So yeah, those are the three deals that come to mind right now. Tell me what you guys think. Quick recap, not sure about Golden Tate. Definitely fills in a wide receiver spot though, which is why we should not go after a wide receiver within the first three rounds of this draft. For Marcus Golden, low risk, high reward. We'll see how it plays out, but I'm excited for him. And then for Anthuan Bethea, he comes in as a mentor, and I hope he gives us at least 85% of what he gave the Cardinals. That's it. That's all, folks. Like, share, subscribe, comment. That's about it. You're...